Hello students, good morning to all. I am Sarita. Let us see, discuss about the topic fiber optics. What do you mean by fiber optics? That is waveguide or guiding media. Fiber optics principle: total internal reflection. This material consists of two medium: inner core medium, core, inner medium, core, outer medium, cladding, and center of the axis for fiber optic axis. The center medium core, this refractive index N1, outer medium or surrounding medium cladding, this refractive index N2, and outer material for buffer jacket. Safety this material using buffer jacket or polystyrene material using or copolymer. This fiber optics material, this inside medium for waveguide or guiding media. For example, single light rays passing it. This light beams incident on this core medium, core to cladding, cladding to core, and core to cladding, cladding to core. Light beams are emitted. This core refractive index N1, cladding refractive index N2. But this light beams are transmitted and reflected. This denser medium to rarer medium. This light beams transmitted through this core medium to cladding medium and cladding medium to core medium, core medium to cladding. That is, this light beams passing inner core, total internal reflection produces. And next, propagation of light beams. And to find the numerical aperture and acceptance angle theta naught or theta. First, you consider the fiber optics cable wire. These are, you see this cable wire, television cable wire. That is fiber optics. These are inner medium core, outer medium cladding, and center for fiber optic axis. This core, refractive index N1, cladding, refractive index N2, and outer air medium, this refractive index N0. First, you can consider this inside acceptance cone, right? Acceptance cone O, center core medium O, consider this cone shape A in A and A dash. This acceptance cone, this light beams are passing in one side OA, this angle of incidence theta I or theta 1. This light beams incident OA directions. This light beams incident in this core medium. After that, cladding transmitter reflected this light beams, but this angle for theta 1, or that is, this is for theta naught, using theta naught, that is theta 1. Core medium to cladding, this is a core medium inside where angle of incident ray, and core to cladding, this is an angle of reflected ray or refracted ray produces. This light beams instant on this cladding. This again touch this cladding, this medium for be considered OB. This B angle in the core and cladding angle difference, that is theta 1, same angle for incident and reflected, and that is this angle for theta C or critical angle. Theta C equal to 90 degree minus theta 1, critical angle. And second one, applying Snell's law basis, again this light beams incident on this B point. This angle, incident angle theta C, and after that this angle refracted ray produces in the cladding medium 90 degree refracted ray produces. And next refracted ray after again cladding to core medium, light beams for reflected, and core to cladding, cladding to core, total internal reflection for produces. A laser principle occur. First one, applying Snell's law. For outside conditions, acceptance cone A dash, angle of incidence of ray for OA, the angle of incidence angle theta naught, the refracted index for N naught, which angle for incident sin theta angle, the sin theta naught equal to N naught sin theta naught equal to inside this core medium, after that for refracted ray produces. This refracted ray produces for core medium. But that is N1 refractive index and sin theta 1. Next, sin theta naught equal to N1 by N naught into sin theta 1. This for core refractive index and air refractive index ratio. Sir, Snell's law, angle of incident ray equal to angle of refracted ray produces. So this OA ray angles are find out. Next step, applying Snell's law. Core medium to cladding medium or denser medium to rarer medium. But this core refractive index N1, where angle for sin theta R or like sin theta C, critical angle, that is equal to cladding refractive index N2, where angle refracted ray 90 degree angle produces. N1 refractive index core medium sin theta C for 90 degree minus theta 1, angle of incident ray, and N2 into sin 90 degree. N1 sin of 90 minus theta 1 cos theta 1. This theta 1 meaning angle of refracted ray cos theta R equal to N2 sin 90 degree 1 cos theta R equal to N2 by N1. Next, this equation number 2 considered. And first equation number, sin theta naught, equation number 1. First equation, applying Snell's law basics at OA ray. This equation, sin theta naught equal to N1 by N0 sin theta 1. That is N1 by N0 sin theta 1 meaning angle of refracted ray. Theta R consider. Sin theta naught equal to N1 by N0 root of 1 minus cos squared theta R. This theta R changing it, 1 minus cos squared theta R. Sin theta naught equal to N1 by N0 root of 1 minus, already second equation given cos theta R equal to N2 by N1. You have to substitute this equation, cos squared theta R. when squaring this equation, n2 squared by n1 squared. Again, simplified this equation, n1 by n naught root of n cross product multiplied n1 squared minus n2 squared divided by n1 squared. And root of 1 by n1 squared, release it outside, n1 by n naught into 1 by n1 into root of n1 squared minus n2 squared. n1 n1 cancel and 1 by n naught root of n1 squared minus n2 squared. That is sin theta naught. Sin theta naught meaning theta maximum. Maximum angle. Theta maximum equal to sin inverse of root of n1 squared minus n2 squared divided by n naught. That is acceptance angle. Light beams passing one end to the another end, total internal reflection produces this maximum angle calculated. That is acceptance angle. Sign of the acceptance angle is called the numerical aperture. Numerical aperture equal to root of n1 squared minus n2 squared divided by n naught. To find this equation, theta naught angle of incidence. Theta naught angle of incidence. Na equal to root of n1 squared minus n2 squared divided by n naught. Co-refractive index value, cladding refractive index squaring value, difference find out. The squaring value for numerical aperture. Sin theta naught greater than sin theta I. Sin theta I less than root of n1 squared minus n2 squared. Sin theta I less than numerical aperture. For refractive index, for air median n0 equal to 1. Na equal to root of n1 squared minus n2 squared. Next is fractional index change. It represents delta. Fractional index change. Using this numerical aperture and acceptance angle formula. Delta equal to refractive index of the core and cladding differences. N1 minus N2. Refractive index core and cladding differences to the core refractive index. You can multiply this equation, N1 delta equal to N1 minus N2. This is a relation between the fractional index delta and numerical aperture. And next, numerical aperture, Na equal to root of N1 squared minus N2 squared. Na equal to root of, this is a squared minus b squared formula. You can simplify n1 plus n2 into n1 minus n2. A plus b into a minus b. Numerical aperture equal to root of n1 plus n2 into n1 minus n2. n1 minus n2 already find out n1 delta substitute. And next, n1 and n2 for same. Core refractive index and cladding refractive index is the same value considered. Root of 2n1 into n1 into delta. Root of 2 n1 into n1 squared into delta. We can simplify this equation. Remove this n1. n1 outside here. Root of 2 delta. That is numerical aperture. So, relation between the numerical aperture and the fractional index change value. That's all.